Super Mario Odyssey is out, and it's just as good as everyone hoped it would be. Today, I'm going to be celebrating the release of the game by doing an analysis of Jump Up Superstar, the game's main theme. Now, I don't have any huge music theory background, I am a bit of a musician, but I don't have formal training in anything like composition or whatever, so I'm not going to go super in-depth to that kind of thing. So this is mostly going to be just an analysis of the lyrics and the references and hidden details in there. Now, it's worth noting that I'm recording this audio Thursday night before the game releases, so anything you see on screen is just going to be whatever random gameplay I decided to record and put in the video, with any spoilers taken out. So if you really don't want to see anything from the game, there's nothing in the visuals that's going to be important to any point I make in the video, so you feel free to minimize your tab and just go do something else while listening to the video. Also, I'm not going to be playing much of the original song in the video at all, just to avoid copyright, so it's mostly going to be that in the background. So if you, it would help to read the lyrics at least once before listening to the rest of this video, just so you sort of know what I'm talking about. I think that's all I needed to say, so let's jump right in. Okay, I know I literally just said I wouldn't be analyzing the song much as a piece of music, but since I'm going to be going through the lyrics in order, it makes the most sense to put all of that stuff right at the beginning. First thing you'll notice is the key of the song is C major. That's not a particularly unique thing, but it is worth noting because it's the same key as the Super Mario Bros. 1 overworld,
aka the main theme of the entire series,
as well as the Super Mario Bros. 3 overworld, Bob-omb Battlefield 64's main theme, 3D Land's main theme, and the overworld theme from the original New Super Mario Bros. It also jumps up into E-flat major at one point, which is the same as the main themes from both Galaxy games. So, right off the bat, without even hearing any notes just by looking at the key signature, it already has strong ties to the main themes of a lot of previous Mario games. Also, just by listening to the first few measures before the voice even comes in, you can tell that it's a big band style jazz song, which is kind of the trademark style of the series. It was more used in the older games up through 64 and then made a bit of a big comeback in 3D World, but it's kind of been there the entire time. So this is a very good fit, genre-wise, for a song that's paying tribute to the entire series' history. The instrumentation, and especially the really brassy intro, is also very similar to the remix of the Super Mario Bros. 1 overworld theme from Smash 4, which also used the same sort of instrumentation style. Alright, took us 2.5 minutes, but we're finally into the actual lyrics of the song. The first line is, "Here we go, off the rails." And I think you can see at least one of the references in here. "Here we go" is one of Mario's most recognizable catchphrases, and I might just be misremembering this because I was really young at the time, but I'm pretty sure that they used it in promotional material a lot to try to make it, like, the catchphrase of the entire series at one point, at least in North America, in the early Wii era. I know there was one New Super Mario Bros. Wii commercial that used it that way, and I think there were some advertisements that used it. I don't know if there were more commercials or if they put it on other stuff besides that, but it's kind of been his thing to say since 64, so if you're gonna start your song with some Mario quote, this is probably the best one to use. As for the second half of the line, it's a little harder to decipher what it actually means, but if you think of Odyssey in the context of the previous 3D Mario games, it makes a little more sense. This is the first 3D Mario since Sunshine to follow an open world level format as opposed to a linear one. As in, the level design is literally going off the rails for the first time since 2002. Second line, "Don't you know it's time to raise our sails?" This one's really straightforward. All it is talking about the fact that the airship Odyssey that you use to travel between worlds in the game has a sail on it, and raising the sails means you're going, doing the adventure thing. You're playing the game. Next line, "You could say my hat is off to you." This one's probably the most obvious line in the entire song. Pretty sure everyone knows that hats are kind of important in Odyssey at this point. Next up is, "Oh, we can zoom all the way to the moon." This one's another straightforward one. It's a reference to two things, actually. First off, the power moons that you're collecting, the main collectible of the game, so that makes sense. And second off, that moon, the moon above Odyssey's Earth, is really big and prominent and probably plays a big role in the game, so I think it has to do with that as well as the fact that you're actually collecting moons. I don't know what the actual importance of that moon is, I haven't played the game yet, but I'm sure it has something important in it. "From this great wide wacky world." This is probably the biggest stretch in terms of it actually being a reference to something. They probably chose wacky for another W word that had two syllables, but This could, with very small chance of actually being true, be a reference to Super Mario's Wacky World, a cancelled platformer for the Philips CDI of all consoles that would have been a sequel to Super Mario World, that had levels based on real-world locations, like how a lot of Odyssey's kingdoms are direct references to places or cultures in our real Earth. And this would technically be the first official acknowledgement of anything related to the CDI from Nintendo, pretty much since they stopped promoting the games for it, so I kinda hope this is a reference, even though it's probably not, but I don't know. Alright, now we're getting to the point where not every line has a reference in it, so I will be skipping lines, but I will be going in order throughout the rest of the song. So after a couple lines, there's a small melodic phrase after the second line in the pre-chorus and leading into the chorus proper. This sounds very similar to a phrase that plays sort of the same role in the battle theme from the original Paper Mario, which is really cool, because if that was intentional, they're referencing the RPGs in here too, which they usually don't do in the mainline games. The chorus itself is pretty self-explanatory and tied mostly only to the narrative of the song itself, just using words and phrases based on things from the Mario franchise, until you get to I'm flipping the switch, which, well, I think I'll let you figure out what that one's a reference to on your own. Just a little bit after that part of the chorus is the bridge, the part of the song with a repetition of Odyssey, yes, see, for a few seconds before it leads into the second verse. This is where the jump into E-flat takes place. Now, the entire E-flat thing I talked about before, but the bass line in this part is a gradually transforming riff on the 25 meters theme from the original Donkey Kong, which is actually the second piece of originally composed music that you'd hear in the very first Mario game, the original Donkey Kong arcade machine. And this is even more fitting, since in-universe, the character singing it is Pauline, who debuted in DK Arcade, and up until now usually only appeared in the Mario vs. Donkey Kong games. Plus, she's the mayor of New Donk City, a world that's completely based on the DK Arcade version of New York, and is full of DK references in and of itself, so this is like at least a triple-layered reference at this point, I think. Moving on to the second verse, the first line isn't a significant reference to anything as far as I know, but the second one is every journey starts a new romance. This could be a reference to how Pauline was Mario's girlfriend in the original Donkey Kong name, but now Peach is his love interest, or just romanticizing the concept of adventure in general, some high literary thing like that. Next two lines are a new world's calling out to you, take a turn off the path. There are again multiple possibilities to the meaning of this. It's either encouraging people to take the risk and play the new game, or another reference to the game structure in Odyssey with a huge non-linearity, or just a reference to the 3D Mario tradition of finding new levels or secrets in interesting ways. The next line after that is find a new addition to the cast, which is sort of a callback through the entire series to how the cast has grown from a man, a woman, and an ape to such a huge iconic group over the years, and how each game usually introduces at least one new iconic character. This case, presumably they're referring to Cappy. You know that any captain needs a crew. Now, again, this is pre-release, I haven't played the game yet, and I've been avoiding most spoilers, so I don't know if any of this is true, but this could be a reference to a few things. First off, it could just be a throwaway line, they needed something to fill space. Second off, it could be referencing the fact that Mario was technically the captain of a starship shaped like his head in Galaxy 2. It could be a Captain Toad reference, I know he's in the game, but I don't know if he's significant enough to get a reference in the theme song. Or it could be a hint that many characters from across the Mario canon, besides just Pauline, will be returning in Odyssey, being the whole Mario crew to match up with the DK crew, or the DK crew shows up and it is the Mario, I don't know. It's complicated. Take it in stride as you move, side to side. This one's really cool, I thought it didn't mean anything for a bit, and then I realized, wait a minute, it's calling back to Mario's roots as a 2D platformer, where moving side to side was the only way you could move. That one's really cool, and I actually needed to think about that one for a few minutes. They're just different points of view. That could be another throwaway line, but I like to think that it's a small joke on the fact that camera angles were always the weakness of the 3D Mario games, so talking about points of view is something related to that, but this one's also a bit of a stretch. This one's not related to the song at all, since the second repeat of the chorus with different words also doesn't contain much, but the line that talks of panache brought back memories of the first time I played Mario 64 DS when I was a bit younger, and the flavor text for unlocking Luigi in the game says something about you can pummel enemies with panache when you unlock him. I didn't know what panache meant, when I'd never seen the word when I first played the game, so I thought it was pronounced pan-ache and had something to do with pancakes for several years until I finally like read a dictionary or saw it in some other context and figured out what it's meant. My little brain was really confused there. I thought Luigi hit you with pancakes or something. I was really disappointed when Luigi didn't do anything with pancakes in that game. Anyway, we're moving on now to the last few lines of the song, and in my opinion, these are actually rather beautiful. Now listen, all you boys and girls, all around the world. Don't be afraid to get up and move. You know that we're all superstars. Those are the first four lines of this ending section of the song, which is sort of a repeat of the chorus, but not really. That part isn't important. Anyway, from context and earlier lyrics, we already know that boy and girl in this situation doesn't just refer to children, so this is talking to everyone around the world that Pauline considers a superstar. My thought process for this is it's referring to everyone who's ever enjoyed a Mario game in the past 36 years. The phrase superstar is obviously something that comes up in a bunch of Mario games, but it also makes me think of the phrase you're a super player, which used to show up a bit in older games in the series. I think this is saying that everyone from every background or walk of life, whether they grew up with the games like I did, are only recently getting into them, or have only played them in passing, no matter what console generation, who they are, where they're from, anything, they're one of the group, one of the millions of people who have been touched by the franchise over the years. Put a smile on that face. This one, I think, is really simple and straightforward. It's just reminding you of the pretty much Nintendo's entire mantra of games should be fun. This game is trying to make you have fun, and that's all there is to it. There's no time to waste. Oh, let's do the Odyssey. I read this one as inviting everyone who's ever played Mario in the past to come with him again on a new adventure, one that's at the same time a loving tribute to the entire series' history and a bold new step towards the future. Now, obviously, from a marketing standpoint, this wouldn't just apply to people who've played games in the series before, they want everyone to buy it, but in terms of the meaning of the song, the entire game is a huge callback and a huge send-up to pretty much everything everyone loves about Mario, so reminding people of that stuff in the end, and having them come back because this is the next big thing, I think, is a really good, really effective, and a really poignant way to end on. But anyway, I think I've been talking for long enough, so I'll let all of you go play Super Mario Odyssey for yourself now. Till next time, this is Luxon, signing off. Me, grab coins with me, oh yeah!